Chalmers for the tie. Wow! Oh, my goodness!
Jordan, Michael Jordan.
From the campus of Texas A&M University in College Station, it's the number one team in college basketball, the Kentucky Wildcats and the Texas A&M Aggies. Three unbeatens left in the country with Kentucky at the head of the class. And a pleasant good afternoon, everyone, along with Clark Kellogg. Kevin Harlan, thank you so much for joining us today. Can Kentucky go the distance and stay unbeaten?
Not in a much improved SEC conference. I think clearly Kentucky is capable of that, but I don't think they'll get it done. They'll stub their toe because they're still a relatively young team.
A terrific team from top to bottom, but led by the versatile seven-footer in the middle, Willie Cauley-Stein.
Kevin, he is 7 feet of sinew and high-energy activity. Willie Cauley-Stein gets it done in both ends. Really imposes his presence on the game with his length and activity defensively. Terrific in shot blocking and steals for this team, but also an excellent offensive rebounder as well. You always enjoy watching a guy like him do what he does at both ends.
The Aggies come in at 9-4. They've won 2 of 3. And what kind of game do you expect with them in Kentucky today?
Well, you know what? You talk to the Aggies folks, and they're interested in taking advantage of this opportunity. And we're going to take a look at the AT&T Fast Analysis to go a little deeper. For Texas A&M, Alex Caruso really is their heart and soul. He led the SEC in assists last year, leading the league in that category this year. He's a guy who makes plays not only offensively for others, but also with his hustle and his activity at the defensive end. When he's going well, Texas A&M is very good. For Kentucky, they want to take advantage of the imposing front line that they have. A number of big guys that can get it done inside. Here you see pick and roll action and then the nice lead. They want to pound the paint here this afternoon.
The Kentucky Wildcats are on the road in the Southeastern Conference for the first time this season in College Station against the Aggies. Our tip-off is next on CBS. CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by Microsoft Surface. By Dr. Pepper, always one of a kind. And by Sonic's new Little Doggies.
It's game time. Strike out the MC. And if he tempts me, I knock him out like Jack Dempsey.
Knock him out the box. Knock him out the box.
And you know, and I know, I'm nice like that.
Back at Reed Arena in College Station, Texas, home of the 9-4 Aggies, taking on John Calipari in his sixth season with Kentucky and the 14-0 Cats. And now Microsoft Surface takes us first on the court. Let's take a look at their five this afternoon on the road in the Southeastern Conference. The Harrison Twins, Aaron and Andrew, comprise the backcourt with a long front line of Cauley-Stein, Towns, and Trey Lyles. Lyles, a terrific looking freshman. Caruso, Green, and House will be the three in the backcourt for the Aggies, with Antoine Space and Courtney Robertson up front for Texas A&M. They are coached by Billy Kennedy, who is in his fourth year, before this at Murray State for five. He has got the program rolling with a terrific recruiting class coming in next year as they make the transition. But today, Clark, he'll be without Jalen Jones, the Aggies' leading scorer, leading shot blocker, and leading rebounder.
Suffering from a high ankle sprain that he suffered in the win against Hartford, did not play against Alabama, and only practiced as recently as Thursday.
On officials this afternoon, Tony Green, who has officiated in 7 Final Fours with Tony Henderson and Brian Shea. Clark, I don't think the expectations are any higher for any program in the country than for Kentucky.
And deservedly so. This program has one of the richest traditions and histories in all of college basketball, and the talent level is unquestioned, and the coaching acumen superb here under John Calipari. So that's what you get when you face Kentucky.
There is a shove down low. They were defending Carl Anthony Towns. Robertson will pick it up. Courtney Robertson, who's a senior from Arcadia, Louisiana. It is the first on him.
And that's the last thing that Billy Kennedy wants is his senior big guy picking up an early foul. He told us he's going to shuffle in big guys in pairs to try to counteract the Kentucky side.
Aaron Harrison with the miss with the offensive rebound by Cauley Stein. Lyles will pick it up. And they'll reset the offense.
Zone defense here by the Aggies. They want to pack it in and force Kentucky to shoot outside shots and then trust that they'll miss them. Then the other part is you've got the defensive rebound effectively, which is hard out of the zone.
Another Aaron Harrison shot. Another miss. This time it's corralled by Courtney Robertson. The Aggies are 7-0 at home, and as we said before, they've won 2 of 3, although they are coming off the loss earlier this week Tuesday at Alabama by 21 points in Tuscaloosa. Caruso, who now feeds to House and Robertson, and they pay attention to him down low.
Mm-hmm, no double team, though. He's got a chance to go one-on-one.
Cauley Stein is there. Great hands, terrific feet. Lyles up ahead. And that is a travel, and it's called on Aaron Harrison. They grew up not far from here in Richmond, Texas, so they're back home in Texas with friends and family watching John Calipari's Wildcats take on the Aggies this afternoon.
Well, Texas A&M's game plan today, Kevin, is to score quickly if they can in transition when that opportunity avails itself. If not, they want to try to score late in the clock.
It's Caruso with a wonderful feed on top coming in from the senior Jordan Green. So that follows what you were talking about right there. Scoring early in the clock. Kentucky was taken to overtime earlier this week in Lexington at Rupp against Ole Miss. Cauley Stein with a nice twirl and picked up by Green. And here come the Aggies the other way.
Again, no double team on Roberson. Robertson, he's got to go to work and be effective in there. Pretty good shot attempt that time.
Space saves it. House with a three. That is Daniel House, a junior from Sugarland, Texas. He is a transfer from the University of Houston. Another assist for Jordan Green.
And good offense allows you to get your defense set in the half court. So a good start here on those last two possessions by the Aggies.
That's a Towns miss, the freshman from Piscataway, New Jersey. And Caruso, the top assist man in the Southeastern Conference, gets it once again down to Robertson, facing Towns. Lyles, now the Harrisons have it. Andrew Harrison, the three. With a rebound right there, pulled in by House. The drive inside. He works up against the defense of Lyles. And a Kentucky foul. It goes against Trey Lyles.
Here you take a look. Caruso's got the ball here. He's just going to make a basket cut after the pass. And take a look at the head of Andrew Harrison. He loses sight of his man. Actually loses sight of the ball. And as a result, good, efficient offensive execution by Texas A&M, and that's exactly what they'll need, Kevin. They've got to convert on those opportunities when they get them. Robertson has gotten a couple of good shots inside and has been unable to convert, and we've got
the platoon thing again.
Yeah, platoon,
going
but we also have a couple of Texas A&M guys going out as well. Robertson takes a seat.
Dylan Johns will come in place of him. Mm-hmm. At the free throw line is Daniel House, Kentucky, and this platoon system has been talked about, and John has done this in the past, certainly, but he didn't like the 0-5 start by his offense with his starters.
Well, he wants to get a little more energy and execution, really wants to try to get that ball inside. Kentucky has settled for perimeter shots here in the early going.
This is Tyler Ulis. Booker is in there. Dakari Johnson is in the contest for the Cats. Marcus Lee is in the game. Lyles remains for Kentucky 5. Dakari Johnson double twisting and knocked away inside by Space. 7 Kentucky possessions, nothing to show for it. House will take it. Caruso. A little mismatch here now against Dakari Johnson.
Boy, would like to see Alex Caruso be more shot hungry in that kind of situation. Good look there. Good decision and a good look by Caruso that time.
Johnson at the other end, rejected by Dylan Johns from England.
Inspired effort here by the Aggies. I mean, defensively, they've been outstanding after the first possession when they gave up an offensive rebound.
Even though school is not in session here in College Station, a good house to watch number one Kentucky and 9-4 Texas A&M house. The swerve, the drive!
Tell me you thought we would be going to our first media timeout with Kentucky being blanked. If it was ping pong, Kevin, we'd be starting a new game. Nice drive here by House. Penetration, hoop, and harm. Aggies up big right now.
Well, we've got an early lead here for Texas A&M, and you can see what's happened in the past to top number one teams early on their conference road.
And that's why conference play is another level of intensity and fortification for whatever team, whatever kind of team you're going to be. I love conference play for that reason. Familiarity. You play true road games in conference play. Neutral site games are not road games. When you get into your conference where coaches and other players are familiar with who you are and what you do, and you can get them on your home court, it changes the dynamic, and we're seeing that here in the early going with Texas A&M. Other than missing three free throws, which when you're the underdog and you're at home, you can ill afford to leave that kind of cheese at the line. But other than that, they've defended the way they wanted to defend in the first segment, and they've also gotten good shots. Post-up touches for Robertson early, and then good movement and execution off the pass penetration and dribble penetration.
Couple of A&M substitutions. Peyton Allen has come in. Tavario Miller has come in, and there is a pick right there by Miller. And Caruso with that aggressive move inside, the snap outside, and now here's John, the freshman Allen, and Caruso. They're paying attention more to him, it looks like, in this defensive set for the Cats.
Mm-hmm. Well, he makes things go for the Aggies. Love to create and find other people or do that.
Wow. A lot of points in the paint, Clark. In fact, a 6-0 advantage in the lane, up close for Texas A&M.
And Kevin, Kentucky is just out of rhythm here offensively. Credit the defense of Texas A&M. They've got them well scouted, and they understand exactly what they're trying to do, which is force perimeter shot. But you can't leave him. He's made 12 of his last 14 from three in the last few games.
That is Devin Booker, the number one three-point shooter on Kentucky, and now they go 1 of 8 to start the game here and down by 6. Miller the screen. The try for House, and again, more points in the paint for the Aggies. He's got 7. He's 3 of 3 to start, and outside Lyles. He'll put in a 3, the second for the Kentucky Wildcat offense.
Yeah, nice pseudo penetration that time by Euless, the top dime dropper in the SEC. All you need to do is force a little bit of help, and then you can create a shot for somebody else. Nice job here by Alex Caruso. Beautiful use of the window, going up over the shot block attempt.
And then House, the transfer from the University of Houston, with a nice move.
And again, Kevin, Billy Kennedy told us this team wants to attack early if they can, but if not, they want to execute and then score late in the clock. They've had a couple of quick hits that have been fruitful.
Look at Willie Cauley-Stein defending on the perimeter with that long reach. Shot clock at 20.
I'll tell you what, Kevin, if there's any player that you would want to put an isolated camera on and not really worry about where the ball was, it would be Willie Cauley-Stein defensively. So active.
Another drive inside. More points in the paint. Allen, the freshman from outside Springfield, Illinois, putting in 2 right there for the Aggies, and their lead is at 7. A&M is led by as many as 9, and Kentucky has not had a lead yet. Aaron Harrison, 3. Rebound by Miller. One thing is always a team like Kentucky, any team on the road, weathering the early emotional storm.
Well said.
House.
They've got to defend better, though. They are not in their stance defensively, Kevin, because they've gotten beat a number of times on drives. They haven't challenged shots. They have been very lethargic thus far at the defensive end, have the Wildcats, and they're the number one field goal percentage defensive team in the country.
Daniel House has hit his 2nd 3 for Texas A&M. 10 early on, and the lead is 10 for A&M over Kentucky. We're back in College Station. Get the fastest scores and updates for Kentucky, Texas A&M, and all teams with the CBS Sports app, the fastest app for sports fans. Download the CBS Sports app now. They go inside here for Towns. Rebound by Miller. So Tavario Miller has come off the bench with a couple of early rebounds. And now they've got another freshman in there, Alex Robinson, with the ball right now, going up against Euless, freshman against freshman.
Yeah, impressive in what I've seen of Alex Robinson, the freshman for the Aggies. I've watched a handful of games, and he's got good poise, can get into the lane. They're really excited about his future.
Robinson, Towns, Miller, knock away inside once again by Carl Anthony Towns. And Euless the other way. Aaron Harrison, what a move to the rack. Another rebound for Texas A&M. Allen, he throws it away. And Booker to Harrison at the other end. Aaron puts it in with ease. The fast break points there and the points off turnover. Right now, A&M is plus three in rebounding. And on the defensive glass, they've been very effective getting those Kentucky misses. Kentucky has missed 10 so far. 3 of 13 shooting for the Cats. Allen lasers one inside, and look at the great Kentucky defense close the door. Devin Booker. He's hit two threes coming off the bench. He is a flamethrower from outside, a 49% three-point shooter.
He sure is, Kevin. I mean, when he gets his feet set, he is a fantastic three-point shooter. Good drive that time. Create the foul by Robinson, but Kentucky getting a little more active defensively, and then Booker able to cash in with the money ball. Big Blue Nation loves that.
We're back in College Station. Every game that Kentucky steps on the floor, home or road, is like a Super Bowl for their opponent. They've got the target on their back, and rightly so, and they accept it. But it's got to be tough that every night you get your opposition's best punch.
Yeah, and you know what, Kevin? It's part of the privilege and responsibility of being at Kentucky. And yet, because of that, that's part of why I don't think they can go unbeaten. When you factor in, this is a relatively young team that's continuing to grow, as are just about most teams across the country at this stage. But John Calipari has a great sense of what it takes to be successful, and he has to kind of restart the lesson plan each year because of so many new players, and no different this year.
Good point. And we got Texas A&M with a kid with 10 points, House, and they're playing right now free and easy.
And relishing the opportunity to do something many don't think they can do, which is not only beat Kentucky, but to compete with them. So it always lends itself to motivated play. You're at home, you're an underdog, great opportunity. How many times do you get to play the number one team in the country as a Division I basketball player? It doesn't happen a lot.
We'll ask Ole Miss. They had that opportunity in Lexington, and they took the Cats to overtime.
And played well. I thought they made shots, they created shots, really good guards that could make plays. Played with freedom and confidence. And Kentucky did not play poorly in that game. Mississippi took it to them, and to Kentucky's credit, they found a way to get it done in an extra session.
Ole Miss in that game played in Lexington, shot 49% from the field, and that was good. Kentucky had 28 more free throw attempts in that game. It was a miss by Euless. Inside, again, a third rebound is lassoed by Tavaro Miller from Long Island, the Bahamas.
Yeah, that young fellow's done a nice job in his minutes off the bench for Billy Kennedy. And Texas A&M has done a nice job limiting Kentucky to just one shot since early in the ballgame.
Robertson against Cauley Stein. Booker throwing a hand to defense in there. And again, they score in the paint. And now in the lane, it's plus eight for Texas A&M.
Keep an eye on that number, Kevin. That could be a huge factor in terms of the Aggies being able to prevail in this one.
Third Kentucky turnover right there.
Robertson's been getting one-on-one coverage, and he's had some good opportunities. This is the first one he's able to convert. Good patience, and he got his body into the shot blocker. That's one way you negate shot blocking. You've got to find that guy that's defending you, feel him, and then get into him. And Robertson did a nice job of that.
So Kentucky has Euless at the point, Andrew Harrison, Dakari Johnson, Aaron Harrison, and then the talented freshman Trey Lyles. That's the Kentucky five. Robertson on top, Miller on the wing. They go to the freshman across the way, and that's Robinson on the floor. The world's greatest detectives are back together in New York, and there's never been a better time to get on their case. Johnny Lee Miller is Sherlock Holmes in A New Elementary. Thursday at 10, 9 Central only, CBS. House and Harrison. Euless will watch Alex Robinson with the ball, a freshman from Arlington, Texas. Plenty of time, but a travel right there, a turnover for the Aggies.
Only the second turnover, I think, for Texas A&M thus far, so good solid execution.
A nice talk with Billy Kennedy, the fourth-year coach of the Yankees. Got a terrific recruiting class coming in. His health, too. I know people were concerned about that over his time here, and feeling great, looking great.
Yep, and feeling good about the direction of this program. Feels like they're right on the cusp of being able to make another big positive step forward. It's been a matter of consistency for this group.
Wildcats are 4 of 17. Now they got Andrew Harrison inside with the crash and the foul on A&M. Robinson hits the deck hard, and he picks up the foul. That is the first on Alex Robinson. Like I said, Kentucky had 28 more free throws than Ole Miss in Lexington in game one of the conference, and here's the first Kentucky free throw this afternoon.
Good job by Andrew Harrison off that turnover to go right to the rim. I always felt like anytime you had the ball, you had decent ball skills and defenders backpedaling in the open court, you should get the shot you want. And that time Andrew Harrison did, took his time, and now he'll at best be one of two from the line as he missed that first one.
Russo's in, and Antoine Space comes in for Miller. The missed free throw there at the back end.
Kevin, you and I were talking during the break. It feels like the Aggies should be up much more.
It does, doesn't it?
When you consider Kentucky just missed two free throws there, really shooting the ball poorly, credit the defense and rebounding of Texas A&M. This guy's been a house of fire. Daniel Housen short on that one.
Rebound by Lyles. The aggressiveness inside. Robertson once and twice.
Wow.
And out of bounds and off Kentucky.
Kevin, when you are the underdog, I know we got a long way to go in this game, okay? Good effort here by Caruso. Pops it loose, and then Robertson just undershot it from 2 feet. But anyway, the point I was about to make, when you're the underdog and you get those kinds of opportunities, you can't leave them wanting.
The margin for error
is
so thin.
Paper thin.
Under 9 to go in the first half from College Station. Against Johnson, it's Robinson. Robertson puts it in. Now he's cleaning up well with an offensive rebound and two.
Well, if you're John Calipari, you certainly don't like the energy that your team is playing with at this point, because Texas A&M clearly playing with more urgency thus far.
A turnover right there for the Cats. You know, John talks about that a lot.
Yep.
All they're going to say now, it is off A&M, and so Kentucky will retain possession. But John talks about showing energy, playing with passion, almost more than anything else, more than the X's and O's. It's about that first, and then everything else falls underneath.
I agree wholeheartedly, and you have to be able to drum that up. And that's what young teams have to understand and learn. And it's a process.
And there's a wild-looking pass that Aaron Harrison grabs from Booker. And here's Andrew Harrison. Points in the paint. A&M plus 12. 14-2 over Kentucky with points in close. Shot clock is down to 6. Andrew Harrison. And grabbed offensively that time by Marcus Lee. Kosher Morales is now in for A&M. Aaron Harrison, a three.
Terrific. That is beautiful basketball there. Dribble penetration, go opposite, and get an open look.
Aaron's got 5, and the answer at the other end with a deuce. House continues to score well. He's got 12.
And this is the Daniel House that the coaching staff thought they would see. He missed some time early.
Devin Booker.
Wow.
What
my
shot.
Goodness.
Terrific stroke. these three-point shots, and he's 3 of 3 from beyond the arc here to begin the game.
That fella's got a clip.
There's Caruso, the former ball boy growing up here in College Station. Tetrosha Morales. Gardenia, Colombia. He is a 6'10 freshman with a world of talent. And they go to Dakari Johnson inside, who is shoved by House. And a foul. House will pick it up and a timeout. This score will surprise some people around the country with Texas A&M up by 7. They've led by as many as 10. And this is House, who's got 12 for the Aggies this afternoon. Well, we're about halfway through this first half. A 16-point advantage in the paint for the Aggies over the Wildcats. And Texas A&M Clark, 7-0 at home. They've led in this one by as many as 10.
Yeah, and seems like they should lead by more. They've had some opportunities they haven't converted. But credit Kentucky. Kind of John Calipari trying to find a group that would play with more energy defensively. And then you add in that better defense with timely three-point shooting, and they're very much within striking distance right now.
And again, their best player is not playing this afternoon with a high ankle sprain, Jalen Jones, so other guys have had to pick up the slack.
Just call him a house of fire. Daniel House has been terrific off the dribble, getting to the rim. He's knocked down a couple of threes. He's been very much on top of his game. And typically when you're without your leading scorer, a player you rely on, other guys have to man up and step up. And so far, House doing that.
Cauley Stein is in the game. There's Booker. Ulis is at the point. They've got Andrew Harrison and Marcus Lee, the Kentucky five. Trosha Morales is on the perimeter right there. Space in the contest over Caruso. The shot by Booker. And a miss. And that is a whistle. And a foul Tuesday on CBS. It's a new year in New Orleans, and the good times are rolling. Don't miss TV's number one news show, NCIS New Orleans. New episode Tuesday at 9, 8 Central. Only CBS. Andrew Harrison picks up his first personal foul for Kentucky. A&M shooting 52%. Wildcats are 30%. And Kentucky is only allowing 31% shooting from its foes this season. Far and away the best defensive team in college basketball, but time after time, smashing moves, Alex Robinson comes up with two.
Shooting percentage, a function of the kinds of shots you get, and Texas A&M is making a home in the paint here in the first half.
Here's Ulis, a freshman from Lima, Ohio. It is high school ball in Chicago. Miles goes inside with double-team defense on Cauley Stein, led by Antoine Space.
Terrific job by the front line of the Aggies the first 14 minutes of this half. Kentucky has not gotten many opportunities inside, and when they have, they've not been clean. They've been challenged at the rim.
We're going in the rafters that time for Caruso with a feed from the wing. Trosha Morales was in there fighting for the ball. Watch this defense.
Good reaction. Two guys from the Aggies going up top against Stein. Cauley Stein faded away a little bit there. Instead of turning into the goal, he kind of drifted, and that allowed the Aggies defenders space primarily to deny that shot opportunity.
Willie Cauley Stein is left, and Carl Anthony Towns has come in with under 6 to go in the first half from College Station. Kentucky has never led. Their deficit has been as high as 10, over 50% shooting for Texas A&M this afternoon. Shot clock at 5. Robinson with the mismatch on Lyles. Maneuvers, fakes, and leans. It's the biggest lead at 12 for Texas A&M.
Well, that was pretty good poise by that young fellow. He saw the shot clock, understood where it was, used the ball fake, and this crowd here at Reed Arena starting to make their presence felt.
They're on their feet. Here's the 5'9", Tyler Ulis. So pivotal in that win over Louisville. The drive inside by Lyles. With the volleyball and picked up by Alex Caruso. This match is Kentucky's biggest deficit of the season right now. And how about Robinson, the freshman from Arlington moments ago for A&M? He was a top 10 ranked high school point guard in the country.
Well, you see the shot clock there at the top of your screen, down to one when he lets it go. But he became aware of it at about the 8-second mark. Knew what he needed to do, had a bigger defender on him, so got him off balance. That was Trey Lyles who flew out of the picture after the ball fake, but an excellent demonstration of poise by Alex Robinson there.
Caruso throws it away and thought he was held. And like I said, the guy that just threw it away is the number one assist man in the Southeastern Conference. And here's some of the notes right here.
Well, there you see they've stumbled a bit here. Had a real tough go of it at Alabama. Tell you what, folks, keep an eye on Anthony Grant's team. The Alabama Crimson Tide, I think, can make some noise this season.
They go inside, but look at the white jerseys all over. Karl Anthony Towns, who slithers in and comes up with his first two. And it was Alabama, as we mentioned earlier, that took care of the Aggies Tuesday in Tuscaloosa by 21.
Yeah, really clamped down on them. The Aggies struggled to find offense in that game. But no such problem so far today, particularly when you consider what the game plan was coming in. Score early if we can, and then late if we have to, and then play good, stingy, tough defense.
Well, the whistle blew as the spinning Alex Caruso just called for the travel for Texas A&M. Towns moments ago, and there was a lot of traffic in his way.
Yeah, but I love the way this young man can work down low. Tough shot there. And that's where Kentucky wants to go the rest of this half, I think. Play inside out. Make sure your bigs get touches, and then the big guys have to demand the ball in the post and really work against this zone defense to get position.
Kentucky shooting 30%. Towns on top. Ball is deflected. And the shot clock at 21. When we come back to College Station with the Aggies on top of number one ranked Kentucky on CBS. Today at 4 Eastern, the road to the Final Four continues on CBS Sports Network as the DePaul Blue Demons look to continue their hot start in the Big East against 8th-ranked Villanova, only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports, CBS Sports Network. Right here you see a Texas A&M lead over number one Kentucky. Points in the paint have been the way for the Aggies early on.
Yeah, pretty good defense too. I mean, they came in, the Aggies, having blocked just 33 shots in 13 games. That's less than three a game. And they've already blocked three here in the first half of this one. And doing a really good job of winning the points in the paint battle. And they've done it by dribble driving. And then once or twice, they've made nice passes off good cuts to score in the paint. Zone defense now. They've mixed defenses, Kevin. They've shown both zone and man-to-man. It's too much time for Andrew Harrison. And Kentucky just continues to chip away at it. And they've had to do it primarily with the three-point shot.
Andrew Harrison gets his first basket to fall. The three right there. Three-point shooting for Kentucky. 6 of 11, 2 of 3 for A&M.
Well, Kentucky comes in here, Kevin, having made 36 of 75 threes in the last four, just under 50%. So that part of the game for the Wildcats has been percolating of late.
That was a pretty early shot by Peyton Allen, and it was outside. And you looked over at Billy Kennedy, and I think he thought maybe they could work it around just a little bit longer.
Big, very important segment here for the Aggies. They've controlled this game for 17 minutes, and they've gotten a tad sloppy the last few possessions, and as a result, Kentucky just two possessions away from perhaps tying it.
Aaron Harrison for Booker. That's Devin Booker. His dad, Melvin Booker, played at the University of Missouri.
Uh-huh. Terrific player.
For Norm Stewart. Towns. Aaron Harrison, a triple. And Robertson tries to control. Lyles is right there. Another rebound, the fourth for Robertson.
Good job, too, to volleyball that one back to himself. And now they need a good, solid offensive possession.
They do.
And it's been a little bit off the rails for the Aggies the last few trips.
2.5 to play in the half. The steal by Aaron Harrison. Miller is there, and he knocks it away. It was clean. And then the foul on the foul by Towns.
Terrific play both ways. I like the fact that Aaron Harrison tried to punch this. He felt Miller coming, but Miller never gave up on it and was able to get it cleanly. Another turnover, though. Good anticipation by Harrison. Pretty good recovery, too, by Miller.
The freshman, Carl Anthony Towns, at the free throw line, a 71% free throw shooter. He was the Gatorade National High School Player of the Year. Player of the Year in the state of New Jersey. Leads the team in shot blocking. And as Cal was saying earlier this week, I need more effort out of him. I got to see more.
And that's part of what you're trying to get young players to understand. What kind of intensity and focus they have to bring every game, every practice. But it's not easy.
Kentucky on a 6-0 run. Approaching 2 to play in the first half with House. He's been quiet of late. Inside, doubled with the good Kentucky defense and a 2-on-1 to Harrison. Andrew from Harrison, from Aaron Harrison, and the tap-in on the follow by Carl Anthony Towns.
That's the kind of energy John Calipari's talking about. Really ran the floor, never gave up on the play, and we've got a whistle here underneath. But terrific job by Carl Anthony Towns. Assumed this would be missed and was able to clean up the miss after Harrison wasn't able to convert. Oh, there we go. A little getting to know each other there between Miller and Andrew Harrison.
Cauley Stein is coming in. There was a delay of game called on Andrew Harrison.
Well, I like what Kentucky has shown. It's not been pretty. It's not been highly efficient. But they find themselves grinding out from under an 11-point deficit just a couple of minutes ago.
Full court here. With Space taking it the other way. Space a transfer from Florida State. Robinson, beautiful look away. Roberson inside, can't get it, and picked up by Kentucky's Carl Anthony Towns with a whistle. Coming up on the AT&T at the half, Adam Zucker, Seth Davis, and Doug Gottlieb have the latest scores and highlights, as well as their opinions on the trending topics all over college basketball. That's coming up on the AT&T at the half from our CBS studios in New York. 8-0 run for Kentucky. Robertson picks up his second personal foul for the Aggies, and 1:32 to go. And again, A&M without their leading scorer and rebounder, Jalen Jones, high ankle sprain, a transfer from SMU, who has played well, didn't play the other night against Alabama, and in a boot, a protective boot, this afternoon on the sideline. Andrew Harrison with a good-looking rebound by Willie Cauley-Stein. Files claims it inside, and a fresh shot clock with which to work for the Cats.
Kentucky has asserted itself here in the last 4 minutes, Kevin, at both ends.
A&M scoreless the last 4.5 minutes. There's a whistle and a foul. It goes on Towns, who picks up his first. Kentucky coming in number one, unbeaten, and the number one defensive team in the country.
Take a look. A lot of activity. There you go. Space got an arm right into the face there of Carl Anthony Towns. Got to be strong when you go into that paint, Kevin. Can't come in there weak.
Especially Kentucky. Kentucky is off to one of the best starts in the great history of their program, but today on the road in College Station, bringing in their number one defense, led by John Calipari. They've trailed by as many as 11, and Kentucky has not led Clark in this first half.
Oh, it's been wire to wire for the Aggies, but here in the last 4 minutes or so, the defense has picked up, and as a result, Kentucky has cut that 11-point deficit to just 3. The Aggies have turned it over, and Kentucky's defense has been outstanding. Good look for House, and a challenge 3. And Kentucky now still about an 8-second difference between game and shot clock.
Trey Lyles. About 7 seconds. Mm-hmm. Maybe just a hair under. Game clock to shot clock.
Got to be good on the defensive glass if a shot is taken and missed here by Kentucky.
Booker leads the catch with 9. 12 for House. Clock at four. The drive by Aaron Harrison. An offensive foul. Aaron Harrison from nearby Richmond, Texas, picks up his second personal foul for the Cats.
Solid job defensively that time, and Texas A&M has been quite good in the half court. It's really been off the turnovers here in the last few minutes where Kentucky has been able to trim the deficit.
Aaron will sit out. Booker's back in. Lee in the game. Hollerstein remains. Andrew Harrison in the contest. Miles. The drive by Robinson. They've had about five of those, Clark, they've missed, and those are the ones that make the difference in a game like this.
And yet, they still lead going into halftime.
Pretty amazing, but they go scoreless the last five and a half of the half. But Kentucky finishes things with an 8-0 run. That's the end of the first half with a three-point Texas A&M lead in College Station. Now to our CBS studios in New York and Adam Zucker. CBS Sports College basketball coverage is sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings, Wings, Beer, Sports. The new venture card from Capital One. And by AT&T, mobilizing your world. Welcome back to College Station. This is the closest it has been since 2-0. Kentucky now to within three. They've trailed by as many as 11 as we take a look at our Buick first half statistics. And the points in the paint standing out right there, Clark, among many things that has made this a very interesting first half. Let's now take a look at some of that and what that has meant in this contest.
Well, I thought Kentucky's defensive disposition early was terrible. Texas A&M was able to get what they wanted off dribble drives, off cutting and passing, and really dominated points in the paint, as we see here. That's been the difference. Kentucky picked it up a little bit, I thought, the last 5 or 6 minutes defensively, and as a result got some turnovers and then knocked down some three-point shots. But the defensive disposition has to change. Kentucky has to come out with a mindset defensively. That's who they are. They've got to embrace that and impose that on Texas A&M. The Aggies, on the other hand, have to keep doing what they did in the first half. Sustain the controlling of tempo, take care of the ball, and get good looks every trip. The last 3 minutes, they turned it over a little too much, and then they've got to convert at a higher rate. I know they shot just under 50%, 45% in that first half, but they have to convert more of their good chances, do the Aggies.
It's Booker, who is hitting the threes in the first half with a runner right here in close. Space tries to get it. He can't. And Towns, and then Willie Cauley-Stein scores for the first time this afternoon for Kentucky. And they go the other way with A&M. They've been scoreless their last eight possessions. 0 of 5, three turnovers to close out their first half offense.
And already you can see the energy level of the Wildcats on display there, coming up with that loose ball, an offensive rebound. And then here defensively, you see much more activity. But just not giving up here. The Wildcats battling, and then Cauley-Stein able to clean it up and finish it off.
Cauley-Stein picks up his first personal foul. This is an undefeated Kentucky team. Only three left with Duke and UVA. Duke will be on the air on CBS tomorrow. Green from outside, and he'll be picked up quickly by Ulis.
And you talk about being undefeated. You've got to be really good, but you've got to have a commitment and consistency to playing at a high level and being able to win when you're not playing your best. And Kentucky being pushed right here as Aaron Harrison takes a hard fall. Caruso just wouldn't give up on the play. But another turnover leading to a runout for Kentucky. Nice job by Aaron Harrison to shoot the gap. And then there you see the foul. Got a lot of ball, but got plenty of arm as well. Good call. The officials right on top of it. But going back to the whole undefeated thing, you know, you don't just have to have talent. There has to be a real understanding of preparation and being able to work through adversity within games. And Kentucky being tested in that manner here right now.
You look at the three unbeatens right there coming into this weekend in college basketball. And Kentucky's schedule, Clark, has contained at one time or another five ranked opponents. They've beaten those ranked opponents by an average of 17 points. And those opponents, all in the top 20 at the time, only shooting 29% combined in their games, with Space taking it in from the wing and fouled on the play. He was run into by Carl Anthony Towns, who picks up his second freshman from Piscataway.
I like what Kentucky's doing here to start the ball, start the second half. Energizing themselves, a little full court pressure there, much more aggressive defensively. They're going to try to speed this pace up, I think, and that's a good move. I mean, it's like when you're playing cards, euchre or spades, and you've got all the trump cards, you play them. You just go ahead and expend them. And that's what Kentucky, I think, will try to do here in the second half.
Spades at the line. So the metrics all say Kentucky's number one. Number one far and away defensively in efficiency with offense and defense. If you go into that realm of analytics, number one. So how hard, and we began the show this way, how hard will it be, you think? And you've kind of touched on it, but to sum it up, this season is going to be filled with the Texas A&Ms of the world, teams that will consider Kentucky their biggest opponent on this schedule.
And that's why I think it'll be very difficult for them to go unblemished. Somebody will probably get them in the conference, and I think it could be a team like LSU on the road. Arkansas is good enough to go into Lexington and win.
Or even today, 6 now for Caruso. Huh?
This one's not done either.
No.
But you look at Alabama, they've got them twice, home and road. Georgia is an improving team.
It is.
Home and road. LSU on the road. I mean, there are a number of conference opponents in an improved SEC that could prove to be a stumbling block for the Wildcats.
Three around Willie Cauley-Stein. Coughs it up right there. Good defense by A&M. Now Jordan Green gets it inside. Look at the defense for Kentucky right there. It's like a butcher shop as they continue to slice away at anybody that has it inside. Booker was going in at the other end. A great rejection by Jordan Green.
Well, both of these teams getting after it. Good to see both ways. Excellent job here. This is where Robertson has to get rid of this. I mean, he's got two guys on him. He should have tried to kick that one out. And a good job by Jordan Green to keep Booker from a clean look in transition.
On a length for this Kentucky team. In fact, until you see him in person, you really can't appreciate it.
Great block out that time by House.
Aaron Harrison with the miss. Oh, we've got some pushing at the other end.
Whoa. What was that? WWE in Reed Arena.
We had Robertson riding the back of Carl Anthony Towns.
And that's a double foul was the first indication.
Watch it again.
Here we are right there, folks. Keep your eye right on that.
And they couldn't get untangled.
Yeah, they just pretzeled up.
Ride 'em, Cowboy.
It's number 12, Carl Anthony Towns of Kentucky.
So it's a third foul on Towns and Robertson. Double foul right there. And that plays into the rest of the half. They're going to sit Towns down. They're going to bring in Dakari Johnson. Here comes Andrew Harrison off the Kentucky bench as well.
Well, that's a big foul for Robertson. Mm-hmm. He's a senior. He's shown that he's physical enough to create some problems inside. Now he's going to have to remain physical and yet do so with discretion. He's got to really be smart here because I think they need him throughout this second half if they're going to pull the upset.
Let's mark this time, 17:40. Yep. See how the teams respond now.
Mm-hmm.
House and Green and a whistle below. Euless will pick up the foul. Freshman, his second.
Wouldn't be surprised to see maybe a quicker whistle initially. Mm-hmm. And then the players have to adjust. It's always incumbent upon the players to adjust. Even if the officiating isn't what you think it should be, the players have to adjust to it.
Here's Alex Caruso getting off to House. With Green on the side. Space down low. Robertson with the ball, setting the screen. The defensive switch. Texas A&M shooting 45%. Kentucky 28% for the game. Shot clock at 9.
And this is where House can try to create off the dribble for himself.
Missing badly. Kentucky's ball.
I think he settled that time, Kevin. He had a little more time. Could have probably kept the bounce alive and tried to beat Lyles off the dribble there.
They are 14-0, Kentucky is, but the season has not had some scars bigger than losing Alex Poitras, who is part of that platooning system, which was even at 5-5. Now it's really nine players he puts into two different groups.
Yeah, and it's a different dynamic now because John Calipari has to figure out which of the one guys that is going to, which one guy is going to stay on the floor when he does so in that manner.
Trey Lyles on top, Andrew Harrison. Short. Offensive rebound pulled down by Lyles. He's now got three. And a new shot clock with which to work for the Cats, who have never led. Johnson the screen. Harrison kicks it outside. Ulis across the lane. Cauley Stein knocked away and fouled inside by Daniel House.
Well, you don't like to give up the offensive rebound there. Good work by Cauley Stein to get to it. But you'd much rather foul him hard and make him earn it from the stripe because he's not a very good free throw shooter.
House with his second foul. Here is Cauley Stein at the line. You know, we've been talking about this undefeated thing, and it's always going to be there as long as the three teams remain unbeaten. But the last two wins by Kentucky, their first wins by single digits. So it's got some asking, you know, some questions about the team. And Calipari has always been one of these guys, Clark, that around the holidays has taken a span of six, seven, eight gameless days and put in, you know, two practices a day and kind of having a training camp round two for his team as he continues to tighten the screws.
Well, trying to refine, trying to grow. And yet, when you don't have game action, you can lose a little bit of your edge. Mm-hmm. There's only so much you can get assimilated in practice. So some of that might be the case. Although Mississippi played really well against Kentucky. It wasn't anything that I think Kentucky was off its game. Mississippi just pushed them hard. And same happening here. Good job by Cauley Stein.
Dylan Johns trying to go up for the A&M team, which leads by one over number one Kentucky. We've had a couple ties and a couple lead changes, and now time to look at the AT&T Fast Analysis.
Some nice eye candy from the eye tracker here. Take a look at Caruso. There he is highlighted. Turns the corner on booking in. A nice little screen there from Miller. Old school pick and roll. Pocket pass, dunk. Beautifully done.
Wildcats have led by one. A&M has led by 11. Still points in the paint, 22-6 in favor of Texas A&M. With a look at Caruso, like we said before, he was a ball boy. Grew up in College Station, a ball boy for this program for many years. And his dad is with the university.
Yeah, dad does the games on radio typically, but I spoke to Mike earlier, and he is simply being a dad today, which is kind of cool. Just going to sit back and enjoy this.
Space couldn't hit it. Johns couldn't corral it. It's pulled down on the play by Trey Lyons. He's got four rebounds. Nice. Following here, screened by Andrew Harrison. Dakari Johnson grabs it and is held and is fouled.
Already the sixth offensive rebound this half for the Wildcats. Again, I thought when they came out to start this second half, that first possession when they came up with a loose ball and got an offensive rebound really has set the tone for the first four-plus minutes here.
Different combinations John Calipari uses with this team. He is mixed and matched all game long, as he's done all season long.
And that's another reason it's going to be hard to beat this team. I don't think this team will go undefeated, but it's hard to beat a team that keeps so much pressure on you at both ends of the floor because of the ability to substitute. And oftentimes when John substitutes, he may gain. He doesn't lose anything. He'll get an injection of defense or three-point shooting when he goes to that bench.
We're in our third tie of the game right now. 15:25 to go. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local CBS station. All tomorrow on CBS with a look at Luck and Manning.
Interesting numbers there. I think the Colts can go out to Denver and get it done, Kevin. You're on top of the football stuff more than me.
They need a healthy Hilton. They go inside with Johns. He's knocked away by Lyles. And here comes Aaron Harrison the other way. Andrew Harrison right down the lane. Untouched. And Kentucky is up with their biggest margin of two after having not led and trailed the entire first half.
Boy, they're starting to really step on it here. Defensively have been much better this half. Nice denial by Lyles. And then late picking up the ball where the Aggies there, and Harrison, Andrew that is, able to get all the way to the rim. And you get the feeling here, Kevin, the inability of Texas A&M to score, Kentucky's defensive disposition really being turned up, has changed the tenor of this game right now. And somehow, some way, the Aggies have to find the bucket. And they're going to have to do it in the half court. That means penetration, solid screens, and somebody's got to be able to knock down a perimeter shot, because not much is being allowed in the paint area so far this half.
Kentucky had that one-point lead early in the second half, then it quickly disappeared. Here's A&M, one field goal the last 10 minutes and 45 seconds of the game, 1 of 11. After beginning so well with over 50% shooting, it's knocked away inside. Roberson with the shot clock at 5. The defense is cranked up, too, for Kentucky,
as you can see. It really has cranked up big time. You can see it and you can feel it. Roberson has to be ready. If he can't make his move quickly, he's got to be ready to kick that ball out and maybe repost and try to get it.
House. Johnson. Andrew Harrison.
This is where the Aggies miss Jalen Jones, who gives them inside score who would have to be tended to by the Wildcats. Now it's basically Roberson.
The A&M leading scorer is out with a high ankle sprain. It's also their leading rebounder. Andrew Harrison will float and a whistle. And a foul on the perimeter. Goes on Robinson, who was defending the freshman guard out of Arlington. And he picks up his second personal foul with a look at Jalen Jones, the junior from Dallas, and a transfer from SMU.
Already the fifth team foul on Texas A&M, Kevin. So that bears watching. You talked about how Kentucky really won the free throw game against Mississippi in a big way.
In terms of attempts.
Right, right. Took 40 of them, I think, in that game, 28 of 40.
Aaron Harrison from his brother Andrew. Rebound by House. He's got 5 boards. House began the game 4 of 4, but he has staggered since in this contest. 1 of 7 since the great start. Miller and House. Russo on the side. Got it from Robinson. And Robinson out there. That's the 5 for the Aggies. As we approach 13 to play in the second half, Miller the screen. Robinson with the shot clock at 4, dancing a bit on Johnson, who falls, then put back up and off by Miller right there. There have been 5 of those this afternoon for the Aggies, and they just can't get them to drop.
At least that many, Kevin. And sometimes when you're facing a team that blocks 8 shots a game and has the length Kentucky does, you'll rush your opportunities inside. And I think that's what happened there with Miller. Rushed it and overshot it after the fortuitous bounce.
First road game of the conference season for Kentucky, with a drive inside by House. And a foul, and Willie Cauley-Stein will pick up the foul. He's got now 2 on him. The junior from Olathe, Kansas.
Well, I really think Daniel House, Alex Caruso are going to have to be the catalyst offensively here for Texas A&M. They've got to try to create shot opportunities and be hungry looking for their shots.
Now 67% from the line. Let's take a look at Daniel House, A&M's junior guard, number 1 season with the Aggie program after 2 years with the Houston Cougars. He was the Conference USA Freshman of the Year. And his 11.5 points per game, second highest on the team, and he leads the team with 17 made threes. And, of course, he came out firing this afternoon.
Only got 1 of the 2 free throws there.
And the free throw story, as you can see. Lee is in. Lewis on the side. Lyles on top. Booker on the wing. And down low, they got Towns. That's the Wildcat 5. 12.5 to go. Towns. And now Booker the triple. Got it!
That's a great pass by Towns. He took his time and got it right to the opposite side.
He is 4 of 5 on threes. A miss inside by House, who has gone stone cold as he plays a little twister there with Marcus Lee.
Here we take a look at Booker. Towns doing a nice job here. Anytime you get that ball in the post, if you can look opposite, if you don't have your own shot, because the defense rotates to the ball, you look opposite, you should have somebody loose, and Booker is lethal from behind that three-point line.
A&M shot about 45% from the field in the first half, now at 33%. Here's the turnover with Booker the other way. And foul. Devin Booker from Grand Rapids, Michigan. He finished up his high school playing down in Mississippi. Robertson picks up his fourth personal foul. That is not good news for the shorthanded Aggies.
Terrible news.
Booker at the line, 84% free throw shooter. Terrific, like his dad was. And tomorrow on 60 Minutes, the booming business of legal marijuana. Plus what you need to know about Obamacare. That's tomorrow on 60 Minutes, only CBS. Kentucky from the line, 8-12. Aggies from the line, 3-7. Tuffy winning in overtime earlier this week in Lexington by 3 over the Rebels of Ole Miss. Robinson right down the lane into the defense and gets it to go.
Wow.
That was a pretty play. He's got 6.
It sure was. I mean, I didn't think he had any room there.
You're right. I don't think he saw any room either.
Just kind of shoehorned himself into the lane and then somehow able to spin it up and down. The Aggies still with a little life.
CBS Sports College basketball coverage is sponsored by Coca-Cola. Open a Coke and enjoy the game. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up. And by Buick. 5 expectation-shattering models. Another reason to experience the new Buick. Well, I don't know, sometimes when you're Kentucky and as good as you are with that kind of history, you don't have to put anything on there at all.
Nothing, do you? At all. Anything
blue. The blue speaks, yeah.
That's right.
Well, Kentucky is plus 15 points beyond the three-point line. They have had 3 more offensive rebounds, meaning second-chance points, and they've out-rebounded the Aggies this afternoon by 4. So those are the numbers now which are trending toward the Caps.
And trending in a big way. Huge basket here by Robinson as we went to break. He'll have a chance to make it a three-point play, but there you see the free throw difference. Points in the paint still in favor of Texas A&M, but most of that was in the first half. But you just get the sense Kentucky starting to wear down this Texas A&M team. So hard to score against Kentucky, and when you don't make the free ones and you miss open perimeter shots, then you just compound your issue. But again, I'll go back to what I said at the start of this half. I thought Kentucky came out with a totally different disposition to get the lead here.
House, he drops the sledgehammer. He's got 15. That might get this A&M team kick-started. Kentucky is led by as many as 6. The Aggies led the entire first half and by as many as 11. We've had 3 lead changes and 3 times. It's Ulis in a lot of traffic. And they come the other way, and he stepped out of bounds. Robinson is off to the races.
This is what you've got to do. Nice job by Robinson to come in and dig out that steal. Good leave, and then house! Trying to bring the house down with that punch. But that's what you've got to do against shot blockers. You've got to get to the rim with strength.
Carson Moleros is now for this A&M team. From Columbia, the freshman at 6'10". Booker and Harrison. That's Andrew with the ball and outside to his brother Aaron, a 3 with a space rebound. Space and house and Robinson and the new entrant, freshman Peyton Allen, in the contest with Trosha Morelos.
He's an excellent 3-point shooter, is Allen, but the Wildcats not going to let him loose.
This week, Dave's all new with the Big Bang Theory's Simon Helberg, Amanda Peet, Anderson Cooper, and Monday, it'll be Chef Gordon Ramsay. Only CBS.
Boy, that was Harrison who made a foolish foul there. He got all over Allen for no reason.
Aaron picks up his third. Allen at the line. Let's go back to that foul moments ago.
There he is. He just grabbed him. Went do-si-do with him.
Peyton Allen, his dad played some college ball at Idaho State. A&M's on a 6-0 run. Another tie, the fourth of the game. Kentucky after trailing the entire first half. Went up by 6 moments ago. Now tied. Number one, unbeaten Kentucky. A second win for the Aggies. Kentucky has one in double figures. That is Devin Booker. And Drew Harrison contorts and drives. And Detrosha Morelos and a foul called on the freshman.
Well, that's one of the things John Calipari wants to see Andrew Harrison do more of. He's got a unique ability. And at his size, he's shifty, good enough with the ball that he can get into the paint. On occasion, he'll settle for perimeter shots. But I think the rest of this half, he's going to be really intent on trying to drive that thing to the paint.
So these Harrison twins, now 0-3 from the line. Andrew, the number one point guard coming out of Travis High School in Richmond, and his brother Aaron was the number one two guard in high school basketball out of Travis, state champion. Saved inside by Towns. Out of bounds with the ball and shoved on the play, and Trosha Morelos will pick up the foul. That is the second on him.
Can't happen. You've got to squeeze that inside guy, and he just beat you. He beat a smaller guy there, did Towns. Great work by him. But boy, you've got to be really aggressive in your box out on that free throw line against Kentucky.
Towns at the line. I can only imagine how aggressive, how intense these Kentucky practices are when you basically have two starting groups on the team.
No question about it, Kevin. I mean, those practices are really entertaining and competitive.
They got in yesterday and practiced, and then they practiced this morning at 7 a.m. here in College Station. Got the kids up early. Outside space. Who had space but couldn't get it? Towns. Andrew Harrison. And that's a shot, and that is a foul. That's going to go again on Alex Robinson. He's got three.
I don't think there's any reason for Andrew Harrison to do anything but look to probe and attack, especially since Kentucky is in the bonus. Put pressure on that defender.
You can see how this Kentucky team, with all the expectations and all the tremendous talent they get as freshmen, and dealing with that as an 18-year-old, 19-year-old kid on the road, and how it builds throughout the season, how you get a little bit calloused, and sometimes you begin to block things out, block out the noise and the clutter. But it takes time. It's a process.
Well, we saw it last year with a number of these kids on this team. You know, they showed you flashes during the regular season, but it didn't really all come together until that tournament run all the way to the championship game.
Robinson scooping and tapping in his own miss.
I like this young guy. Boy, he's been impressive.
He got on his pogo stick and
he did. He knew where the miss was going to come off. And I like his tenacity too. He's really competed hard out here. Let's have all the Aggies.
9.5 to go in the second half here in College Station. With a whistle down low, another Aggie foul. Trosha Morelos will pick it up for the Aggies. Number three.
Alex Robinson here beats his guy and then gets it up on the glass. But before anybody else could react to it, able to get it down.
Towns with a look at Robinson. He's a young player. They've got four terrific high school kids that have committed, all top 65 kids in the country, all from Texas, that have committed for Coach Billy Kennedy and his program now in its fourth year with him as the coach.
Really, the trend is a green arrow for Billy Kennedy and this program. And I still think this team can get Jalen Jones back healthy and stay together as they go through some bumps here. Could still make some noise even this season.
You know, Alex Robinson will be guy at the steering wheel as a freshman right now, learning a lot, taking control.
He'll be an integral part of it.
Another steal with the clean breakaway by Aaron Harrison. Dropping it at the other end. And Kentucky up by six. This equals their biggest lead. A&M has been up by as many as 11 with under 9 to go in the second half.
A&M just came all the way back from a six-point deficit. Can they do it again?
It's a lot.
Yep, it sure is, Kevin.
They've spent a lot of energy on number one Kentucky. The Wildcats led by sophomore Aaron Harrison, riding the magic carpet in for two for the Cats. So Kentucky on top by six. They're shooting from the floor just 29%. A&M shooting 37%. It's interesting when you can go on the road within your own conference and shoot under 30% and have a six-point lead with under 9 to go.
That's why I think this is the most imposing team in the country, Kevin, because they're showing you here so far that even when not on top of its game offensively, the defense can be stifling.
It always travels, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Space with Cauley Stein getting suckered in there and ramming into him. The Kentucky defense, number one in points allowed in college basketball, number one field goal defense, number one shot blocking defense, top five in rebounding, number one margin of wins. I mean, the numbers are staggering.
They really are. And it's even more impressive seeing them when they do it at a high level. I mean, the numbers are just a shadow of how imposing this defense is when you're out there going up against them. Another missed free throw. This the front end of a one-and-one by Space.
Willie Cauley-Stein just picked up his third.
So Kentucky on the verge of cracking this one open, Kevin. You can just feel it. Zone defense here by Texas A&M. You've got to not only be mindful of the three-point line, especially with Aaron Harrison, but then you've got to get to defensive rebounds if the shot is missed.
That ball had some serious gas on it, and the throw by Carl Anthony Towns, and it goes whistling out of bounds.
I like the idea. That's the right idea. That's where you want to go with it when it gets to the middle, diagonal, but he just was a little high and hot with the pass.
Sometimes you want to be high and hot, but not on a play like that. Here we go with House. Robertson.
Where does offense come from here? I think Alex Caruso has to look to shoot it a little more. He loved to create, but he was indecisive there.
He was. It almost like he was going to hesitate in mid-flight. House tries to force the issue. Knocked away. Aaron Harrison will come the other way for the Cats. Andrew to Aaron. 7.5 to go. Think about Kentucky. They just don't blink, do they?
They don't. That's so impressive, too. That's one of the impressive qualities. This group loves playing together. They play hard. They started slowly. That's an offensive foul on Carl Anthony Towns. Illegal screen.
All right, we'll step aside. With Kentucky on top, you're watching college basketball on CBS. It is the first road game in conference play for number one ranked and undefeated Kentucky with Clark Kellogg, Kevin Harlan. The Wildcats, who did not lead Clark in that first half and trailed by as many as 11, have outscored the Aggies in the second half 22-13.
It hasn't been super pretty, but it has been methodical, and it's been because of the defense. The nation's best defensive team, Kentucky, has been able to get it done here in the second half because of altering that disposition defensively and changing shots as they do so. Points off turnovers, denials at the rim, opportunistic threes, but again, all fueled by the defense. And again, it's not been explosive. It's kind of been a bit of a slow roast, if you will. And right now, the Aggies on the verge of being fully cooked if they can't find some offense.
Notable Kentucky performances this afternoon. 9 points, 9 rebounds for Towns. 14 points. Devin Booker, who has knocked in 4 triples. And for A&M, they've gotten 15 points and 6 rebounds by Daniel House. Playing without their leading scorer and rebounder today. Struggling now here in the late stages. Caruso tried to take it and had it poked away. And the shot clock at 22 for the Aggies. A&M, Clark, for Coach Billy Kennedy began 13 of 24 from the floor. Since that time, 4 of 23.
And then a turnover. Yeah. So it's just starting to fall apart here, particularly at the offensive end, but all credit to Kentucky. Been a couple of loose possessions, but it's all been because Kentucky has really gotten out, pressured the ball, and not allowed much easy at the basket.
Both Harrisons, Euless, Willie Cauley-Stein, Dakari Johnson out there for the Cats. 6:49 to play. It's Dakari Johnson out of Brooklyn, New York. Up and off. And claimed inside by Robertson. To Robinson. Kentucky is plus 15 points beyond three. Plus 9 points at the line. The dive by Robertson. The rebound by Johnson. And a foul on A&M.
Well, the inability to convert inside, not being able to get any clean looks on the perimeter as well. Frustrating for Billy Kennedy.
Space picks up his second foul. We talked about the difference at the free throw line with Dakari Johnson up there right now. Significant.
That's a big part of who Kentucky is as well. We talk about these defensive numbers, and they are stellar, as you indicated, but this team grinds you down by getting to the foul line, continuing to keep fresh, talented bodies on the court. And if you can't consistently score and find good shots, it just wears you down, not just physically, but I think it wears you down psychologically and emotionally too, Kevin, when you're trying so hard to find points.
Clark, you rely, like John Calipari does, and a lot of freshmen, a topic talked about a lot, but think about taking these kids from all over the country in different styles of play and different talents, and in one season, basically, is what he's got these kids to work. He's got to mold them into something that resembles a unit.
Yeah, and he mentioned that it is challenging and it does take its toll on him, but he seems to be energized by it as well, Kevin. I mean, and these kids, to their credit, they come in knowing what the resume of John Calipari is and what the track record is.
Know what the landscape is
exactly
when they get there. Yeah,
and I think they're able to embrace it and know they're going to get better and that they're going to have a chance to play for championship.
But there's got to be a time, too, when some of these big-name kids go, well, how long is so-and-so going to be there? Right?
Yeah, I'm sure that's part of it.
You know, because I want to play. Robinson missing badly, and it sails out of bounds. It's off of Kentucky, actually, and A&M will inbound the ball, down by 7, 6:05 to go. But these kids want to play right away, and they don't want to sit. And there's some kids that sit on this Kentucky bench, which will be starting in a lot of programs, most programs in the country.
Yeah, but they wouldn't be at Kentucky.
That's exactly right. That's the trade-off, right? That's the trade-off.
That's right.
And there's a foul on Cauley-Stein. Willie picks up his fourth. When you see a seven-footer like Willie Cauley-Stein and his footwork and his quick hands and the way he defends on the perimeter, it's something that is rare in the college game, isn't it?
Extremely so. Very, very rare. And it'll travel well with him whenever he decides it's time to pursue playing pro basketball. Wow.
Wisely is stuck around. Remember, got hurt last year, and so he couldn't play. And he thought, you know, why leave now when I can be with another good team, coach I like, a system that is making me a better player, and eventually it's going to pay off down the road.
It sure will.
Space.
And you know, you get the feeling this game is pretty much Kentucky's, but I mean, it's a two-possession game.
Absolutely.
With a lot of time left, and the Aggies, if they can find a way to get a stop and a score, I mean, they very much could really put some pressure on Kentucky here.
How do you like them going to the zone here?
I like the zone.
Last couple
shown,
of minutes.
They've shown it most of the time. They've shown it off and on throughout the ball game. And you've got to be able to do that. Rebound out of it.
House with only Andrew Harrison, Aaron Harrison back in house with a nice drive. And he's got 17. He's got 7 in the second half. And now it is a 4-point game. So another breath for the Aggies, who are sticking right in there, punch for punch with number one, Kentucky, and 5.5 to go. Only undefeated teams in the country, and you're seeing two of those undefeated back-to-back, Kentucky today and Duke tomorrow, and then, of course, the big day of sports continues on CBS tomorrow. The divisional round, the AFC playoff game, featuring the Colts and Andrew Luck in Denver to take on arrested Peyton Manning and the Denver Broncos. That's tomorrow on CBS. A great day of TV.
And none of those teams will remain unbeaten, I might add. All of them will get beat at some point.
Yeah, you've been pretty strong in that most of the day.
I mean, the parity, the challenge that's presented, trying to be undefeated in good leagues against good opponents.
Booker the three with three to fire. Pauly Stein got a hand on it. House in the two to the rack. It's a two-point game. Aaron Harrison, a lot of white jerseys around. Retrieved by Caruso. 4.5 to go.
The zone has disrupted Kentucky here the last few possessions, and it's allowed House opportunities at the rim in transition.
Miller was fouled as he went up trying to get the House miss. Somehow find the net. House has been aggressive.
Yes, he has been. And when you can rebound out of the zone, it does launch your fast break a little quicker. And House has been the guy who's made it happen. Excellent take here. And again, defenders backpedaling. I think you should get to the rim every time if you're a baller. And the bench enjoying it. That's Peyton Allen there screaming and hollering. And it's a two-point ball game.
And Willie Cauley-Stein has just fouled out. He is gone. The guy who is at the core of this undefeated season. Now you have the freshman Towns, the freshman Lyles out there on that front line. Willie wearing number 15 going up and trying to defend Miller. It looked like he was almost shoved there by Robertson just a bit. Cauley-Stein finishes with 4 points, 6 boards, and 2 blocks. Miller at the stripe. Tavario Miller from Wheatley High School in Houston. He of the Bahamas. Poor free throw shooting by A&M. Coming in 7-0 at home against undefeated 14-0 Kentucky, number one. With the number one defense in college basketball, pushed to overtime in their first Southeastern Conference game earlier this week and pushed today. It's a three and it's down! Aaron Harrison knocks down a big-time triple. He's got 12. Jackson slithering the other way, finding Robertson inside. Approaching 4 to go.
I think that was a fortuitous bounce more than an assist, but the Aggies will take it. Beautiful job by Andrew Harrison on the last Kentucky possession to get his brother a wide open look because of his penetration.
Willie Cauley-Stein has fouled out. The Harrisons with Andrew chiseling. Booker. Aaron Harrison, another three. Picked up by Caruso. Keeps his balance. Off of, well, let's see, they're going to decide. It's off of Kentucky. Caruso coming up big. And the Aggies to within three with 3:33 to go.
Nice job by Caruso to maintain balance and fired it off of Towns. Andrew Harrison keeping Kentucky on top as he finds his brother. Count that up.
Texas A&M comes into this afternoon 9-4, 7-0 at home. They've won 2 of 3 overall, and they're hanging with number one Kentucky, down by 3, trailing earlier by 11. Kentucky's biggest lead has been 7. We've had 4 ties, 3 lead changes. John Calipari on the road for the first time in conference play. A conference is not getting a great deal of respect in terms of overall quality around the country.
I think that's going to change. I really do. I've not seen everybody in the conference play, but I have seen a number of the teams, and I think this conference is going to be pleasantly surprising to many. You look at LSU, Alabama. I know South Carolina has played well. I've not seen them. Georgia, I've seen a couple of times. That's a decent team. I think this Tennessee, I think this is going to be a better conference than people give it credit for.
The Harrisons and Booker in the backcourt. Lee along with Towns up front for Kentucky. Caruso, Robinson, Miller the screen. Space in Caruso. That's with House out there. The 5 for A&M as Caruso tried to make a move, and a foul was called, and Booker will pick it up It's the number one on freshman Devin Booker.
Well, good ball movement that time and player movement by Texas A&M. And Caruso is a reluctant shooter, so you almost have to play him for the drive, and I think that's where Booker made his mistake. Got up on him and gave him an angle.
Caruso's not been to the line all day.
Pretty reliable free thrower is Caruso. Well, not as reliable as I thought.
About 63%.
Right. I was thinking of somebody else.
It's when they come. That's what you're talking about. When those free throws come.
63% is bad. I don't care.
I'm trying to save you.
I was crossing my wires.
Throwing your life jacket. Put your life jacket in there.
No, you got to let me drown on that.
No. Towns and Booker. Booker today is 14. He's knocked down four triples. 12 from Aaron Harrison. The only two Wildcats in double figures this afternoon. Shot clock at 6. Robinson defending on the perimeter, and the fellow freshman will pick up the foul on the wing. Number 4 on him. Willie Cauley-Stein, as we've mentioned before, joining us late. He's already fouled out for the Cats.
A lot of missed free throws both ways, but Kentucky a little more proficient.
There's Andrew Harrison. Now 3 of 7 from the line. What a tough game Andrew did against Louisville when he was only 1 of 6. Coming in to today after the last couple games together, 3 of 13 combined. Today he's gone 2 of 8 with 9. But when the shots aren't falling, you find other ways to contribute.
That's right. That's exactly right, Kevin. A lot of different things you can do to impact winning.
Short the game now if you're A&M, Clark.
Well, I mean, they've been playing that way all game long, so no reason to change now. I think you've got to be ready to take the first good available shot, though. And they want to play late in the clock, and I understand that, but I would be looking to take the first good shot.
Shot clock at 8 for Robinson. He knocked it in with a long 2. Kentucky's got 3 timeouts. A&M has 2. And a 2-point game with 2 to play.
Back to man-to-man now for Texas A&M. They've done a nice job mixing defenses here all afternoon. This is where you've got to really be down in your stance and try to keep Harrison from getting to the lane.
Shot clock at 7. Andrew Harrison to Aaron Harrison. A triple.
What a play by Caruso.
It was. Robinson the other way.
Gave up his body to keep that ball alive for his teammate.
A&M's going to take a timeout. They've got 1 left. They'll have the ball and 29 seconds on the shot clock. 1:26 to go. This shot right here off the glass, sent home by the freshman Alex Robinson of A&M. Texas A&M has the ball. 29 seconds on this shot clock with 1:26 to go. They've got a timeout remaining, and they're down by 2 to number 1, Kentucky.
Well, this is where you go into your quiver and try to find what play can get you a high-quality shot. What do you have based on what Kentucky has shown you? Alex Robinson, I think, has been terrific. He banked in that last shot, but he's done a nice job orchestrating things. I think you try to throw it inside to Robinson, but really encourage him, if he doesn't have a quick move, to get it kicked out right away so that ball can get swung, or you try to play through house.
Quick read and
quick read,
and
quick read
too.
And then you've got to be ready on the catch if you do get it from inside back out to either shoot it or then drive it. But 29 seconds left on the shot clock. I think they go with what they've been doing. I mean, they're going to try to play late into the clock, and then it's about execution.
Kentucky has 3 timeouts. Caruso will inbound. Robinson will have it. Andrew Harrison will be on him.
See what they got here. Trying to get house free. Good denial. All right, they want to probably flatten it out and let Robinson try to penetrate with the help of a ball screen here. There's a shot. Got a
space for the lead. Robinson claims it inside for A&M.
Well, that's a great look they got.
They're using the clock and holding on to the ball. Space the screen, the switch on defense. House. House, this is for the lead. And that is out of bounds, and it's off Kentucky and off of Karl Anthony Towns. So a couple threes and both off.
And not bad looks, and that ball did go off Karl Anthony Towns.
Dakari Johnson will check in for Towns.
See, I don't know if you a three is not necessary. If you get a good one, take it. But I think you've got to try to take this ball to the basket because you put Kentucky in a position maybe to foul you as well.
Mike Caruso right here. No foul. Johnson gobbles it up.
Now you got a foul. You got a foul here.
Two on one. Andrew Harrison. Picked up by Robertson. House. Up and off, and a foul called on Kentucky.
Wow, what a sequence there.
Aaron Harrison will pick up a foul. He's got four for the Cats.
Well, see, you wonder why not pull it out, but you got a chance to finish the layup here. That's a play you make. I have no problem with that. You attack the rim. You've got transition opportunity there. There was plenty of contact there, not called. Caruso could have very easily been on the line, should have been on the line. And now it's about knocking down free throws, and we know how difficult that's been for the Aggies all game long.
Now 67% from the stripe, as you see. A&M has missed five of their last seven free throws. House 1 of 5. Towns, Trey Lyles check in. Johnson, Marcus Lee check out for Calipari. 18.4 to go. This will be for the tie. House with 21. Andrew Harrison. Aaron Harrison. This timeout, timeout, Kentucky. Timeout, Kentucky, as the ball was just off his fingertips. It shows point three. They will take a look and perhaps readjust
it. Yeah, they will readjust it because John Calipari got the timeout. I think it's about a second or so, not much more than that.
Right now, Kentucky has two timeouts left.
Here's John Calipari here. Let's see when he does take the timeout. He's actually trying to get the official's attention. There it is right there. 1.9, it looks like. Now, when did the official acknowledge it right there? So between 1.5 and 1.9, it looks like to me, is what Kentucky will have.
Good work by our truck and our crew here in College Station to capture that and give you the most accurate read. Texas A&M Clark is on a 12-5 run over the last 6.5 minutes of the second half.
Well, I think the zone defense.
You talked about
some opportunities,
right.
And they got House out in the open court after they rebounded out of it.
So number one, Kentucky went to overtime in their SEC opener earlier this week against Ole Miss, and they're tied right now with what will be probably under 2 seconds remaining as our officiating crew.
You see there, Calipari is indicating the timeout there. The official waves it off, and it looks like 1 point. There it is, right there. It should be right around one. Yeah, one. I'm saying now 1 to 1.4.
1-3.
Somewhere in that neighborhood. Is that what they've determined?
Chosen, okay. Yep.
Well, we know Aaron Harrison, as you look at Tony Green and Brian Shea.
Well, the only other time Kentucky has been here at A&M to play in the modern era, the game went to overtime. And we're on the doorstep of it right now. Kentucky will have the ball. They've got the two timeouts left, 1.3 to go. And Calipari has orchestrated his final shot.
And we know Aaron Harrison, after that tournament run he had a year ago, knocking down 3 game winners. Maybe you throw it inside right away. And Booker, too. Texas A&M going to take a timeout.
Their final timeout. and we will step aside. A thriller in College Station, 53-53 on CBS. We're tied at 53. Kentucky will have the ball. They'll inbound with 1.3 to go in regulation here in College Station, Texas. One of three undefeated teams in college basketball, Kentucky, Duke, and Virginia. And right now, Kentucky being pressed to the limit.
Try to make them catch it away from the goal as best you can if you're Texas A&M. I don't want anything going to the rim.
Aaron Harrison for the win. And he's been in that position before. We go to overtime with A&M and number one Kentucky.
Great look here for a lethal late game shooter, Aaron Harrison. Boy, and he got a clean look. Nice job here. House was there, didn't want to foul him. Late challenge, and it was right on line, just a tad strong.
Yeah, he was out there. Huh? He was like in Richmond, Texas, shooting that shot where he's from. Overtime to come on CBS. Welcome back to College Station, Texas. This overtime on CBS made possible by Buffalo Wild Wings. Number one, Kentucky, led by seven. And A&M has come back. The lead of Kentucky, 48-41, with 6.5 to go. And Clark, how did A&M get back in this game against the top-seeded Cats?
Well, I think the zone defense the last few possessions forced some misses. They rebounded out of it. And House was able to get to the rim a couple of times as a result. This young man, Alec Robinson, has done a nice job playing the point and being good defensively as well. And then Kentucky missed some opportunities. Harrison had a layup that he could have knocked down to put it to a four-point lead with under a minute to go. And now we go an extra 5 minutes of hoops.
So people trying to put this Kentucky team in perspective, going to one of the best groups possibly as the season goes on, but in their first two conference games, two consecutive overtimes. It may not be as easy as some think. Andrew Harrison inside, and he twisted an ankle.
They did get up a little gimpy.
He's grimacing. Robinson's got the ball. As you smell blood here, take advantage of a guy who's hobbled. Caruso.
And that's exactly what he was telling his coaches, Kevin. He wanted to go to work on him.
Robertson gets the space screen, meets the defense of town. Shot clock at seven. Screen by Space, the doubled Robinson. Space, two to fire, the triple. There's Andrew Harrison. Devin Booker. Fouled, he'll go to the line. Count it for two. Big time play and 16 for Devin Booker.
It sure was a big time play. And that's Robertson's fifth foul. He went to the left hand there. Excellent hands by Harrison to come up with that steal. And there you see, just a terrific take. And that was Space actually guilty of the foul, not Robertson. Space commits the foul there and took a hard swipe at the ball and got all face.
Space picks up his third. Booker will be at the line. Kentucky with their first field goal in overtime. They had only one field goal in the last 9 minutes of regulation. It's picked up after the miss. House, Caruso. A&M comes in 9-4, 7-0 at home. Kentucky 14-0, the number one defense in the game, a top ranking. But on the ropes here in their first SEC road game. Caruso to the rack. And picked up inside by Lyles. He's got five boards.
Well, they just challenge everything around that rim. You've got to be a terrific finisher or go in there ready to pass if you don't get a clean look.
Ewells is in with Booker. Aaron is in. Andrew is out.
Two terrific shooters on the wings now for Kentucky, and Booker and Aaron Harrison.
Ewells against Robinson. The dance, the drive, the feed, the Harrison triple. Picked up by Caruso, again hitting the deck and trying to keep it alive. And a travel is called on Alex Caruso.
A tough call, but the right one there. I don't think he was bumped. I think he just went down. Take a look at it here. Yeah, he just fell. That's the right call. can't have the ball and lose your feet. Mm-hmm. That's a walk.
I think he was trying to call time, but I think Kentucky latched onto it so fast.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right, Kevin.
There just wasn't any breathing space there to do so. So Kentucky will inbound with Aaron Harrison. Miller, Robinson, House, Caruso in space for the Yankees. Approaching three to play in overtime. Down by seven. A&M came back. The freshman Ulis. The freshman Lyles.
Hooker and Anthony Towns out there too.
My gosh. Knocked away by Carl Anthony Towns and out of bounds and off of Kentucky.
I think we got a foul there, Kevin.
I think you're right.
Somebody on the back of an Aggie.
It'll go on Towns. And he picks up number five. He is the second Wildcat along with Willie Cauley-Stein to foul out this afternoon.
Where? I didn't see where that was. What happened here? No, there was
incidental, huh? At most.
At most, yeah. He may have gotten.
Yeah,
but that was not a foul. And if anything, he may have just nudged House. And again, it was incidental. I did not see the.
Towns.
Certainly didn't merit a foul call from my vantage point.
9 points, nine rebounds, three blocks. The thing is, when you've got an arm span.
There it is. It happened before against Miller. It happened against Miller. He nudged him. We were looking at House on the backside of that play, and it actually was Miller who had gotten pushed out of the way.
Who is at the line at the other end. 4 of 7 coming into this afternoon from the stripe. And 0-3 this afternoon. The free throw shooting, Texas A&M has not been good. 9 of 20.
I think one or two of those were front ends of one and ones too, Kevin.
You're right.
And yet, still only 1 point down, so got to forget about the misses and get locked into the present.
Kentucky by one. Ulis looking inside, Lyles outside, Booker, shot clock at 8. The zone defense, Lyles, Ulis found him, and Lyles, when going up, was hacked at by Tavario Miller, who picks up his first foul.
Boy, get a little back cut here by Lyles, but up until then, Kentucky very content just to move that ball side to side. Good play up top on the ball, but clearly some body contact that got Miller to foul.
Mr. Basketball in Indiana, and the freshman from Indianapolis, Lyles, has not been to the free throw line this afternoon. He is a 68% free throw shooter for the Cats. He's starting for the injured Alex Poitras.
That's a total of 20 missed free throws between these teams so far. It's a bad day at the line. And it continues.
Yeah, boy, it sure does. A&M with a chance to take a lead here, approaching 2 to play in OT. A&M with a timeout, and Kentucky with 3, and Robinson will control. House. The dance on Booker in the drive, and Booker tried to swipe the ball away and picks up a Kentucky foul.
Well, I like that thinking in your attack in the half court if you're Texas A&M. A little movement, dribble hands offs, and then try to get to the rim, and clearly a foul on Booker. Keep the pressure on the defense, and playing through House off the bounce is a pretty good strategy for Texas A&M.
Off from the line now. 4 of 8 shooting for Daniel House when he came out of high school and Hightower High School in Sugarland, Texas, 26th ranked player in the country out of high school, went to Houston.
He's made his last 4 free throws, too, including 2 to tie it up and send it to overtime.
And he's given his Aggies a 1-point lead, and Kentucky will take a timeout. Number one with under 2 to go in overtime, down by 1. in overtime, and number one Kentucky down by one. Kentucky's tightest game until today came Tuesday against Ole Miss in the conference opener. Stephen Moody scored 25 points for the Rebels, sailing in there. Ole Miss had a chance to win it at the end of regulation. Summers missing a three. We went to overtime. Andrew Harrison's clutch three-pointer in OT put Kentucky up. Martavius Newby missed a three-pointer on Ole Miss's final possession. And Kentucky survives in the opener, game one of the conference schedule, 89-86. Now on the road for the first time in game two of the conference schedule.
Here we go.
Here we go again.
Cauley-Stein has been Dairy Queen, as has Karl-Anthony Towns. And they're watching and looking for their teammates to make enough plays to get out of here with the victory. But the zone defense, the last 5 minutes or so, has been very good to Texas A&M. Kentucky has to probe it with penetration to the middle of the floor with the pass and then be ready to get that ball swung to the opposite side.
Harrison's are in. Ulis is here. Dakari Johnson inside with Lyons. Andrew stepped out of bounds. Lost his footing, walking the tightrope, and out of bounds he goes.
I think that was a case of him being in. Oh, he got a little bit of a bump.
Ooh.
You're right.
Yeah, he did get bumped there. I don't know if he actually made it out of bounds.
I don't think he was either. I agree. We'll have to look at that again. Here comes Robinson. Space on top. Outside, Caruso. Shot clock at 10. A&M with the lead, with the ball. Robinson to the rack. The defense there. Johnson with the ball and gives to Ulis, who sings it out on the wing, and Booker's triple no good, and space is there. Out to Robinson.
Well, didn't need that quick look, but it was an aggressive look for an outstanding three-point shooter, and you still have another possession to go, even if Texas A&M scores here.
A&M a timeout, and the Wildcats have two.
Just don't want to give up a three if you're Kentucky.
Mm-hmm. Caruso, Booker's on it. Screen by Miller. Outside, space, three. Saved by Space, in the house, and a whistle. And a timeout. And a timeout, the final one by A&M, leading by one. And A&M will have the ball. Thanks to this save, the acrobatic Antoine Space. Having some space. Timeout.
Critical call on the possession prior to Texas A&M getting the ball. Harrison bump never seemed to go out of bounds. It looked like he saved that ball before going out of bounds. The officials thought he was out of bounds, gave the ball to Texas A&M. And now Texas A&M, no shot clock, 27 seconds left. We'll have an opportunity to add to the lead. I think Kentucky plays defense here for 5 or 6 seconds and then fouls.
Kentucky a timeout. A&M's out of timeouts with 27 seconds remaining in overtime. Kentucky with a timeout. A&M has the ball and they lead by one. Shot clock is done, 27.3.
As good as you are with Kentucky's defense, I think you clearly play some defense. Oh, wow. Were they looking to foul right away there or not?
Lyles just picked up his second personal foul for Kentucky.
The point I was about to make, because Kentucky is so good defensively, I think you give yourself a chance to maybe force a turnover with so much time left. And then you could foul at the 20-second mark or so. Oh, yeah, he grabbed him. He's all over him right in here.
Miller, 1 of 3. Make it 1 of 4 from the line for A&M. Free throw shooting for both teams poor. But in the game for A&M, when they're trying to upset number one, it's something you got to have.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And when you're trying to stay unbeaten, too, you got to have.
Yeah, I know. 10 of 22 from the stripe for the Aggies today, leading by one. Tavario Miller.
Zone defense, you got to attack it for the paint score. You don't need to look for the three if you're Kentucky here.
Kentucky's got a timeout. Ulis. Booker.
You called it, Kevin. Calipari just indicated to Tony Green that he wanted the timeout call.
18.2 on the clock.
Still wondering if they wanted, I'm not sure if they wanted Lyles to foul there. It's hard without being in the huddle to know, but nonetheless, that's history. They give up one free throw, and now you've got to think about how you're going to attack this zone, which has been problematic for the Wildcats the last 7 minutes or so.
Timeout. Well, you see the game reset. Kentucky's got the ball. And A&M is up by two with 18.2 to go. Timeouts are gone both ways.
Plenty of time left here. I think you've got to try to attack inside. Now, you've got one of the great clutch shooters in Aaron Harrison, certainly based on what he did last year in the NCAA tournament. Three-game winner, all of the three-point variety. But you don't need a three. The key here, Kevin, is to attack early and try to get a quality shot early. So you give yourself a chance, if you do miss it, to get to the offensive glass. And then if you don't get the rebound, then you can foul and try to extend the game. So I think you've got to attack quickly here if you're Kentucky and take a quality shot. It could be a three, but I would say you want to try to drive it or get it inside right away.
Mulis, Aaron Harrison.
He's trying to shoot a three.
Off the rim, picked up by Lyles. And fouled inside. Space and Miller were jousting. Foul goes on Space, the fourth on him.
Nice job by Trey Lyles. Good patience. Got the defenders up with the fake. Now he's got a chance to knock down a couple of free throws.
Lyles 0-2 from the stripe today. 68. 68.
I think he was in this position against Mississippi and missed a couple.
68% for the season. 1 point game, 6.1 to go.
Nothing like a little redemption. He's halfway there. But still plenty of time for Texas A&M to push it and get a last shot off. The big thing is if he does miss, you got to rebound the ball if you're Texas A&M. Kentucky has shown a great ability to get missed free throw rebounds.
Trey Lyles to tie it. They'll bring in Marcus Lee. He'll take the place of Dakari Johnson. 6.1, no timeouts either way. We're tied in overtime. Robinson. The screen by Robertson, and Robinson cannot hit the shot at the buzzer. It is our second overtime coming up in College Station, Texas.
I thought he was much too casual in this pace there. You want to go with more urgency to really put some pressure on. He allowed Kentucky to actually not have to really sweat this out. Part of being a freshman. Growing pains.
Let's go to round two in overtime. We go to our second overtime, and the last time a Wildcat team was in double OT was 2008 against Vanderbilt. The foul situation, Hollystein is gone, as is Towns. And Aaron Harrison has got the three and some foul concerns for Robinson and Robertson.
We had a whopping 8 points scored in that overtime between the two teams. And it's been a low-scoring affair all day long. I would roll the dice if I was either of these teams and try to pick up the pace a little bit. Try to play this overtime like the little four-minute segments
right.
The teams practice playing at a crisp pace. Instead of being a little tentative and trying to squeeze and milk every possession. With a little more freedom in attacking mode.
How about the deep bench of Kentucky? And we know that A&M has been without their best player all day because of a bad ankle. It's a three-point shot. It's launched by Aaron Harrison. It's rebounded by Robinson. And out of bounds went Booker. It's off of Kentucky. And A&M, they have signaled we'll get it.
Well, let's take a look. Robinson on his way out. And boy, it looked again as though that ball was still in play, and the official saw otherwise.
Dakari Johnson is in. Miller, Caruso, along with House, Robinson, and Miller, all in there for the A&M Aggies. And across the lane, Robertson. Beautiful shot. Right on the doorstep.
And
he's got eight.
Able to go one-on-one against Johnson that time, Kevin. And with Carly Stein not out there and Karl Anthony Towns both DQ'd because of fouls, takes away some of that size and length in the paint.
Miles tries to sneak one inside. He does to Dakari Johnson. Beautiful pass.
Excellent execution. Again, the middle of the zone is the soft spot. A nice job by Lyles to go right down inside after he caught it at the foul line.
Sometimes young kids think too much and they put it on the boards, and that's when it becomes a problem.
Right. He knew exactly where he wanted to go with it.
Caruso moving up on the defense of Booker and trying to slip it inside to Robertson. Got it to go and a foul.
Man, that was a heck of a catch. Woo. Terrific pocket pass by Alex Caruso. What a nice catch and finish. And there's Robertson. Getting it done here to start the overtime all by himself here. One-on-one, gets his body on Johnson and then does a nice job going to the left hand. Look at this pocket pass. Boy, and a pretty good catch after the fumble by Robertson.
Booker picked up his third personal foul for the Cats, and at the free throw line is Courtney Robertson from Arcadia, Louisiana. More poor free throw shooting.
Much anybody can do about that from a coaching standpoint.
A&M 13 to 26 from the line. Dakari Johnson defended by Miller.
He got bumped prior
sure
to
did.
It. Tony Henderson with the call there. Being man-to-man this time, and Dakari Johnson has a size advantage on Miller. Able to take advantage of it there.
Dakari Johnson from the free throw line is 2 of 4 from Brooklyn, New York. Played some prep ball down in Florida.
Good looking stroke there.
Yep. Maybe he learned that from his mom. His mom played some college basketball at Long Island University.
Already a brisker pace than we had in that first OT.
You're exactly right.
We got a total of 8 points. And that's all we had in the entire 5 minute first overtime. So both teams being a little more aggressive and quicker to the shot opportunity here.
And tied again. Approaching 3 to play in this second overtime. Caruso working on Booker. Got the screen for Miller. Wheels and finds Robinson. Whoops. I think he thought that House was going to cut, and
yep.
House said was on the brakes.
Yep, you're right. He was anticipating that House was going to flare out to the left. See, he's got a shot if he does flare, but not a misconnection that time, and now you got to ramp it up defensively. See if Kentucky can go back inside against his zone. Lyles at the middle is a key guy. Because if it's caught there, he can dump it down inside to Johnson.
Lyles, 16-footer. Trey Lyles has got 7. And Kentucky leads by 2. Kentucky shooting 33%. A&M shooting 28% in these overtimes. Russo, good catch by Miller. Bumped into by Johnson. Swatted away inside by Lyles.
Man, he's got his hands all over this overtime, doesn't he?
2 blocks.
Trey Lyles. There he is right there. Going to just float, get in the line of vision of Ulis, and then just step back. He could either make the pass, but that time had plenty of time and space to knock down that jumper, and then comes and helps out Dakari Johnson from the weak side to get that block.
Dakari Johnson just checked out. Marcus Lee has come in. House down the lane. Bumped and he'll go to the line as he was pushed that time by Aaron Harrison. He's got 5. Aaron Harrison has picked up his fifth, and he is gone.
Just not in good position with his feet and committed the foul with his body as a result.
Aaron Harrison finishes the afternoon 2-13 on three-point shooting. They rely on him for those shots. I think Andrew Harrison was selected by John Calipari to join Ulis and Booker, Lee. Now we're going to put Dakari Johnson in. Now they get. Not yet. They're not going to put him in, but
right.
He will come in a second.
Shortly. Yep.
But it is Andrew Harrison for his brother, Aaron, who just fouled out. Aaron Harrison is the leading scorer, too, at 11 points a game. But these guys are so bunched up together in scoring,
yeah.
Similar numbers, 1 through 9. That,
yeah. Yeah, I think it's between 7.5 points and 11 that those eight guys are averaging for Kentucky.
We're talking about bad free throw shooting. House is now 6 of 10. He's made 5 consecutive free throws, and he has a new career high in scoring with 24. Daniel House.
Well, you talk to the coaches, and they talked about waiting for House to break out, and today has been a breakout game for him, and this is what they expect from him. Aggressively attacking the goal, knocking down threes when he gets good ones. He's been outstanding today offensively. Done a pretty good job at the defensive end, too.
Another tie. The game's 10th. Ulis. Tyler will get it back again. Robinson will be on him. Freshman against freshman. Shot clock at 9. Minute and a half to play in our second overtime.
Miles is effective as a pick and pop guy.
Ulis, a 3. Bullseye! Big time triple, Tyler Ulis. His first point in the game this afternoon. Couldn't have come at a better time. How will the Aggies respond? Down by 3. Caruso, Robertson, pushed and fouled. Free throws for him. The three-pointer by Tyler Ulis.
Good two-man basketball here. That's Trey Lyles making the nice pass. And then Ulis stepping into that shot with confidence. It's just good offense. A nice challenge by Robertson. Just good shot-making and execution. And here's Robertson at the other end. Almost had an opportunity for an and-one there off the nice pass from Caruso.
First free throw of the afternoon made by Robertson. Here comes space back in, taking the place of Tavario Miller. 58 seconds in the second overtime. Two-point game. Number one, Kentucky, unbeaten at 14-0. They played 5 ranked teams, last of which was against Louisville in a big defensive effort, won by 8 in Louisville. People kind of thought maybe this team would work their way through the Southeastern Conference. But the first game in conference play, overtime in Lexington against Ole Miss. And the Wildcats won by 3. Second game, first on the road in the conference. It's College Station, overtime against 9-4 Texas A&M. Travel, wipe it away. Lyles will turn it over on the travel.
Let's take a look at Lyles here. Yep, picked that pivot up before he was able to put it back on the floor.
Timeout A&M, 26.9 to play in our second overtime. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this word from your local CBS station. It's the second overtime of our afternoon game here on CBS in College Station, Texas. 14-0 Kentucky, 9-4 Texas A&M, coming off a 21-point loss at Tuscaloosa against the Crimson Tide on Tuesday. Kentucky coming off that overtime win of 3 in Lexington over Ole Miss. You see our score. Timeouts, 1 for the Cats, none for the Aggies. And the shot clock is off with 26.9 to go in overtime number 2.
And I see that Peyton Allen has checked in for Texas A&M. He's a 37% three-point shooter. Perhaps is Billy Kennedy thinking about getting a look from behind the arc here?
Euless is on Robinson. Robertson will set a screen. And now it is House. Step back triple. Zachary Johnson's got the ball with a whistle and a A&M foul.
And that's exactly what they were looking for. They were looking to try to take the lead with the triple. Got a pretty decent look from House on the step back.
It's a big miss. Big, big A&M miss.
Yeah, that's
five fouls on Robertson.
Yeah, and that's the other side of it. If you get it to go down, you're up one. That's a good look. Good challenge by Booker. And big time board. Big time board by Zachary Johnson.
Boy, look at that. It's a torture chamber inside. Guys there clawing at the ball. 14.7 to go. Robertson is out. He was a Warrior today. They all had to be at different stages of this game because Jalen Jones, the leading scorer and rebounder for A&M, missing his second consecutive game for Coach Billy Kennedy with a high ankle sprain and a boot on the bench. And here's Johnson at the line. There he is. Johnson from the stripe for Kentucky, 4-6, but 3-3 from the stripe for the Cats in overtime.
Mm-hmm, big.
Big is right.
How about this young team? Taking the two overtimes in great shape here now, but you think about building the fabric of who you are.
Good point.
These are the kinds of games you have to go through.
I don't know if the clock had started on time or maybe it was early. Let's see. They're going to do it again. 14.7 will be on the clock. They have the Cats put in Marcus Lee. Zachary Johnson has gone back to the bench.
Something
good. Chance
of
go Big Blue from a very heavy Kentucky crowd here in College Station.
Got to go quick if you're the Aggies.
Space. And Allen with the three. No. Booker the rebound over the back. Climbing with House. And now 8.2, and Kentucky smells blood. You're right. I mean, here you got the one of the youngest teams in all of college basketball. The average experience of Kentucky is number 345. Out of 351 division schools, which has been the norm in Kentucky for a while since John Calipari has been there. Nonetheless, every experience new. Here's an overtime game on the road.
Very impressive stretch finish here by these Wildcats. And they stay unblemished for another game.
House of three. And Caruso. And that's it. And Kentucky survives. How about this? Two consecutive Southeastern Conference games to begin the season for Calipari and Kentucky. And both go to overtime. And terrific efforts by A&M and Ole Miss earlier in the week in Lexington.
Agreed with everything you said there, Kevin. I mean, you think about how well this Texas A&M team played throughout. And then in the overtime late, two-man game, well executed here by Trey Lyles and Tyler Euless. And this, the biggest shot of that second overtime, gave Kentucky a lead they would not relinquish.
Kentucky goes to 15-0. And in conference play, they go to 2-0. They remain unbeaten. Winning in double overtime in College Station, 70-64. For Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying so long from College Station, Texas, where number one ranked Kentucky has won 70-64 in double overtime. Tomorrow, join us for more hoops as the second ranked Duke Blue Devils take on North Carolina State. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the 2015 Men's National.